In this video, you'll learn about the accelerator effect, but we'll first start by establishing the definition of the listed key terms. After we've covered these terms, then we will look at the accelerator effect and how it is linked to national income. First, let's define capital depreciation. Capital depreciation refers to the decrease in the economic value of a capital asset. For example, suppose a farmer's tractor lasted for 10 years and costs $100,000. That would give it an annual rate of depreciation of 10%. It would depreciate at approximately $10,000 per year for 10 years, at which point the tractor would no longer be operable. Net investment is the part of investment spending that increases the overall capital stock of an economy. Essentially, it is business spending on capital that exceeds the replacement of depreciated assets. Gross investment is equal to the total amount of investment that occurs in an economy over a period of time. It includes spending on new capital equipment, but does not separate out that spending by capital depreciation or additional purchases that increase the size of the economy's national stock. For example, say a farmer replaces a tractor that has broken down due to depreciation and also purchases a brand new tractor in addition to the replacement one. The total of these two purchases together would count as gross investment. So gross investment equals replacement due to depreciation and also net investment. The capital output ratio measures the proportion of output for a firm and the quantity of capital used to produce that output. For example, if a firm uses 10 machines to produce 100 units of output, its capital output ratio is 1 to 10. Autonomous investment is the level of spending firms will undertake regardless of national income. It can be influenced by business expectations, changes in technology, government policy, and interest rates. However, induced investment is the level of spending firms will undertake in response to changes in national income. So induced investment is therefore income elastic. The accelerator effect states that the level of investment by firms is related to the rate of change of national income, not just the change in national income itself. An increase in the rate of national income will result in a larger increase in the overall level of investment. Similarly, a fall in the rate of national income will result in a fall in the level of investment. To understand why this happens, we have to consider two possibilities. First, as consumption increases and then national income increases, firms will meet rising demand by trying to increase production given their current production capacity. If they are able to meet that demand by doing so, they will not spend on expansion. However, if consumption increases, national income increases, and firms are not able to satisfy that demand with current production capacity, then they will likely invest and expand production. Even more so if they believe this trend is likely to continue into the future. Remember, we assume firms will make decisions to maximize profit. If they do not anticipate this surge in demand to persist, it is less likely that they will invest in expansion. If firms see demand continuing to rise and expect the trend to continue, they will invest into expanding production. If firms do not believe the rise will be sustained, they will be less likely to expand production if they do so at all. Let's look at the accelerator effect using a numerical example. I've constructed a simple table using some of the concepts we've just learned. We'll consider a firm's behavior over 2 years and look at consumer demand, how much capital they started with at the beginning of the time period, how much capital the firm needs to produce the given consumer demand, how many machines they need to replace each year, how many new machines they need to buy, or are net or induced investment, and finally, gross investment, which is the total of all spending on replacement capital and new capital. In the first year, consumer demand is equal to 50 units. The total level of capital at the start of the period is 10 units. The capital required to meet demand is 10 units. If the firm needs 10 units of capital to produce 50 units of output, then the capital output ratio is 1 to 5, because each unit of capital can produce 5 units of output. We will hold the assumption that the firm replaces 2 machines per year as they wear out and depreciate. Since the level of capital in this time period is sufficient to meet demand, the firm will not be investing in any new capital. And our gross investment, which is equal to replacement due to depreciation, which is 2 here, and net or induced investment, which is 0, gives us a gross investment total of 2 units of capital. Now, we're going to look at year 2, in which consumer demand rises by 20% to 60 units, right? A change of 10 units from the previous year is an increase of 20%. The firm currently has 10 units of capital because the previous year they wore down 2 machines, but they replaced them. In this year, they're going to need 12 units of capital to produce 60 units. At the end of the year, they're probably going to have to replace 2 machines due to depreciation. But to meet that demand, they're also going to need to purchase 2 new machines to meet the rise in demand, bringing gross investment to 4 units of capital, an increase of 100% from the previous year. From this, we can see that the proportion increase in investment of 100% is significantly larger than the proportion increase in consumer demand, which is 20%. This is the accelerator effect in action. A key question that we now have to answer is whether firms will always respond to changes in demand by increasing investment. The answer, as usual, is that it depends. If firms can meet rising demand by making better use of spare capacity, then investment is less likely to take place. If technology improves, the capital output ratio can change and also reduce the need for further investment as firms can produce more output with lower levels of capital. If capital goods producers are working to capacity, may also reduce the level of capital goods available. In a situation where consumer demand is rising, producers of capital goods may be working to capacity to provide equipment to firms. This can limit the ability of some firms to purchase new equipment. So by now, you should have a strong understanding of the concepts listed here. Beyond that, you should have a clear picture of the accelerator effect and its impact on national income. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below and let's answer them together. That's us done for now, and I will see you in the next one.